My name is Kristan Alfonso. I'm a pediatric otolaryngologist and I come from Atlanta, Georgia. I work as an assistant professor of otolaryngology at Emory University and a pediatric otolaryngologist at Children's Healthcare of Atlanta. So for candidates who come to me asking about the Assia system, it's important for me to relate to them that even though it's a more of a new device, the actual implant itself, the BI-300, has been around for quite some time. So I like to let them know that it's been around for over 10 years. It's been very reliable, and so we have very good data on that itself. I also like to let them know about some of the technological features of it, that we've got the availability for them to be able to swim with it, with using the aqua cover, and then the Bluetooth connectivity tends to be really popular, especially with my teenage patients. With patients that I've had transition or that they've been in a soft band in the past and now have the Assia, one of the things that they really like is the reduced feedback. That's something that I've heard from several patients that they really enjoyed about the Assia. And then I've had patients that really describe the improved sound of music to me as well, that they really enjoy that with the Assia. I consider bone conduction solutions for patients for several different reasons. As a pediatric otolaryngologist, I'm oftentimes seeing patients that have microtia atresia, and so that's a big category of patients with that form of conductive hearing loss that benefit from bone conduction systems. Also, patients who have chronic otitis media and have had a canal wall down cavity, they tend to benefit from this as well and not wearing a traditional hearing aid. And also in the single-sided deafness population. And so typically in that population, we'll explore with workup if they're even eligible for a cochlear implant. And then even for some that might be eligible, they might, under evaluation, decide that they'd rather go with a bone conduction system. And from an Assia lens, reliability is also just as crucially important. Patients also are wondering when we have to go back to replace it. And with now, we know that the sound is being converted into mechanical energy within the device that's implanted itself. We don't want to have to be going in every so often to replace it. And so that's really important for families and for our patients. With this development of the piezoelectric technology, the goal is that with reduced friction of parts, that over time this will be reliable and not need to be replaced.